These are the entries. So I have two entities in this application. This is download or write from my application. So there are two applications. And with these two applications, you can do complete CRUD operations right now. So let us say search list. And you want to save it. So now we will see that list one is selected, is saved here, right? So you get complete end-to-end working application in minutes. You can download it. And the idea is to have a mobile application, if you want to develop it, this kind of mobile application with a different UIs. Within minutes, you can do it. You don't even have to spend time for looking for or creating your own entities. We have a backup, a starter kit. Most of the entities might be, you would be able to see from there. And also we have open entities.org where we are trying to collect. Right now we have 2 billion entities from the Google's Freebase database, which is maintained by Wikileaks right now, Wikipedia right now. And so kind of working on those different things right now. So this is a simple, the platform is called apibot.com. In the middle you have that I is from, sounds like AI. The idea is to create, make the program to write its own program code. So if I'm expanding my code, or the application will understand what I need. If I'm creating a simple CRM, I would start with a simple small CRM application, and then it keep on adding a sales process of this and that, all the logics, and also the UI to be built. So that is the AI part I'm thinking of. Like as mentioned in here, this core website, the application, what you see, the avbot.com, I developed this core platform from the first page using the same platform. So this application is building by itself, evolving by its own. It's generating the code and reusing the code to build its own. That's what I'm doing. So that's my little venture. So I'll better stop it here. If you have any questions, I'll clap. Sure.
Thank you. This is supporting thoughtful and access control to resources.
Which one?
Restriction to resources and volume.
Which one are you asking about? Deployed or my API part?
Yeah, when they create and generate all the endpoints.
Right, so that is the beauty of this application. So like, whatever the modules you want, you can ask for it in the order, right? In the order, I want email module or I want security. So those are the extra, different subscription. So we provide, and the beauty is it also comes with different technologies of your own choice, like Java, Python, the enterprise, in an enterprise like in Wells Fargo when I was working, every single technology as well.
Yeah.
And every team, they just taught it. The beauty of this platform is you have a state-of-the-art code. It's a huge plus for the maintenance, code maintenance. If you bring another developer, he has to use the same pattern of coding. So you will not have no spaghetti code or anything. So you have a beautiful code standard to follow. And also expand it really quick. If you're spending I'm sorry to say this for the developers, including me. If you're spending 3 months to develop an application, this will help you to create and complete an application within within weeks or months.
I had a question regarding, so data store is data, pretty much like data one, or document, a document. How do you work with relational data? For instance, management and relationship, how
is it? Okay, that is the moment, the NoSQL versus SQL, the question. That's not part of this talk, but then so the part is the in an object you JSON field, one of the field, you relate that field to another object. So the field, like I show you real quick.
So you're gonna have a reference to another entity by ID.
Exactly, that's it. So here you have this data type. That data type is going to be object, right? So this is going to be, I'll be mentioning this as well, we only have the address here. So let's say, here we have another object called email, right? So I can mention that as an email. So I'll refer to that object.
Okay. And then, for instance, if you have an API call for FOSS, which that would alter multiple things.
Yes.
How do you do it with events? If you pretty much just work with one entity.
So the query part is pretty interesting. So it is very seamless with MongoDB API. So whatever you are able to do with MongoDB, you should be able to do with putting the collections, right? So here are these these are the query APIs, we call it as with the MongoDB, what are the operators? Sorry, these are the operators that you actually use with the MongoDB, not equal to in. So if you want to search something within the query, you can add all these things. It's all just a JSON object with your query. You just add it. It's not, in a digital regressive query in a relational database. You would put all these things in simple JSON format, and you got it supports the regex, and you can restrict what are the fields you want. You don't want to retrieve all the fields from the particular resource.
Okay, so in order to use it, you have to make sure that you don't have relations. Otherwise, it's just
data. No. You can do the relations.
No, I understand. You can have an extra query, right? The second query to the second table, you can do all you want, but you cannot do it all at once the way you do the installation, right?
In the so if it is a one query within the query, say let us say post. Posting a blog post, okay? The blog post also has some comments. Let us say we are retrieving that, from the post resource. You also want to retrieve all the comments related to that particular post. What you would do is get post. There is a query here in the JSON that you append to that, right? Like var class in SQL, relational, right? The same thing in the query, you put and then in the braces you mentioned that dpd.get commands id equal to id of this this one. It's almost the same, similar, but the only thing is that the syntax will differ a little bit.
Okay.
Did I answer your question? Yeah, I mean, if you're totally new to this document database, it's going to be a really difficult thing to start with. I went through that path, and how can we do this? And because we are completely, my mindset was completely with a bound database, one-to-one. If you change anything in the column or anything, it blows every single tier, every single thing. But here, that's not the case. Sometimes it still works. So you have to do a lot of coding on that. Validation, every end, it becomes your work. And MongoDB paid version helps you in certain cases. Any question?
Yeah, let's assume I have an endpoint that does more than just delivering some data that contains really complicated logic, which is many hundred lines of JavaScript code. Would I put all that into the event handlers, or would I write my own plugin? What would be your workflow for that?
Like I said, these events, as it is, as a fresh code, fresh install, it won't support require. So if you want you want to separate your modules, right, your code into another similar JS file and export that, and make it available, and you make call to the, those methods. You can do that only by installing this extension. That's why I was I wanted to show that in the web.
With the extension, I would add into this directory that I have. I would add my own source files there, and then
any directory. So you would put that, say, this is the folder, and then here you would create. So this is the public, right? So here you would create in this one. New folder. I don't know if it's creating inside or outside. Yeah. So middleware. So you got the middleware, and here you go and create the JS. That's it. And here you put your export.
And then I call that.
And you call that from your and so for this code you have to come here as of the released version, the latest version that you have online, but the ones that we are working that has this part, that you have the access to these files, so you can edit them right here. Like a studio, we are trying to make this a studio. It's already a studio. Right now it only supports those events of the resources, not the other files, the middleware files. So the idea of this deployed for the founders is to create a very simple, quick API generation framework. That's what they started. So they don't want to complicate with much of this. So, but it's not going to stand at that point that, you know, you can, if you cannot break your code into modules, if it is not modularized, there's no use of it. All are asynchronous. So that is another thing. So if you want to create just a hook, web hook, right? Mm-hmm. So this one, what you see here are the resources. These resources are mostly like the database, the database collections, right? This one definitely this has the this is the database collection, but you don't want the data to be stored with the data, the database. But you want to call some kind of action. You just want to do some functions like the email one. In order to do that, you have to create. There's another module that you have to add, which is called DPD event. Right. So this DPD event allows you to induce two events, post and get. It works as a webhook, right? You just to call that endpoint, send a verification email or something, right? That is not storing anything. Or even if you call data store from inside, you have the access to all the resources. So the only one thing, as I said, to answer your question, it's all callbacks, right? But if you are using the dpd.js, the resource, then you don't need to add, the callback is taken care of by the dpd object itself. If you are not, so the dpd is only useful for accessing the local resources, whatever the resources in your server. If you are going to accessing the local files, files you want to access the file, or if you are calling a REST API like Google the chart or something like that, you have to use this add callback and finish callback. Starting before you call that make the call, you call this add callback. So it makes a count on the callback, and then once you say finished, and then it closes the call. So you have that is how it is implemented.
Let's break here, and if there are deeper questions, we can have those be one-on-one afterward. Just want to give people the ability to get up, stand up, move their bodies. So thank you very much.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.